Welcome to Fox Soccer's Triple Header Saturday. We were going to bring you 7.5 hours of live soccer. We started all off with the U.S. national team as they try to further control Group C as they face Panama in Gold Cup action. And we end the night with the Pacific Northwest Derby, the Seattle Sounders, and the Vancouver Whitecaps in their first ever MLS meeting. But we begin the whole night with the return of the USL Pro as the Rochester Rhinos take on the Harrisburg City Islanders. We'll see you at the halftime. Enjoy.
Live from Salem Stadium in Rochester, New York, it's the 2011 debut of the USL Pro Game of the Week on Fox Soccer, and we've got a great matchup for you for the first one out. The hometown Rhinos host the Harrisburg City Islanders in a critical National Division clash. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Western New York. My name is Ken Tomash, and I'm thrilled to be working this year with longtime English goalkeeper and USL technical director, Peter Meller. Partner, you ready?
I'm ready.
All right, we have a great matchup for you the first time out, as we said. The Harrisburg City Islanders come in here having won 3 straight games, and so they are just a point behind Rochester now. They're in 3rd place in the National Division. Rochester's in 2nd place. If either of these teams can win tonight and get the 3 points that go with it, they'll take over 1st place with Los Angeles in the National Division. So, Peter, what do you expect out of this matchup this evening?
Well, I think both teams are looking for consistency, you know, to build on their recent wins. So I think that's going to be a key, and I think we're in for a very enjoyable game.
Rochester has yet to lose at home, and Harrisburg has yet to win on the road. The Rhinos get a key part of their defense back tonight. Troy Roberts, their captain, returns from injury. What does he bring to the side?
I think he's the glue in the defense and also the experience, so I think he just consolidates that whole defense, and I think overall it'll be real tight.
Their captain and inspirational leader as well, and he and the rest of that back four will have their hands full with a Harrisburg attack that has scored 9 goals in their last 3 games. Brian Ombigi is a quick, nice little player who scored 2 goals at midweek. What does he bring to the table?
I think he brings work rate, and he's very, very tricky, but he's all over the field.
Well, we're going to have the first 11s for you as well as the opening kick when we come back after this quick timeout. Don't go away. You're watching the debut of the USL Pro Game of the Week here on Fox Soccer. Stick around.
The legendary New York Cosmos are back, and to mark the club's rebirth, Umbro has applied its celebrated football tailoring ethos to the brand new 2011 collection. Anthem jacket, Cosmos tees, New York Cosmos jersey, 1976-1977 home jersey. For the complete New York Cosmos line, go to soccer.com/Umbro.
Could switching to Geico really save you 15% or more on car insurance? Do people use smartphones to do dumb things?
Send, that is the weekend.
Yeah, dog.
Allow me to crack the bubbly.
Don't mind if I do.
Is a gentleman with a bro stash invited to this party?
Only if he's ready to rock.
Geico, 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
That's my Bob.
Go, go, go!
He used to be just me and him. Then one morning he tries Just for Men. Says here it targets only the gray, fast and easy, replacing it with his natural tones.
Hello, Bob.
Hello.
Apparently that's not the only thing it replaces. I'm glad Bob's happy.
Hi there.
Just for Men. Live forward.
Yeah.
built like a Volkswagen. The 2011 Tiguan.
Also get a free flight.
You know that comes with a private island.
Really?
No, it comes with a hat. You see, airline credit cards promise flights for 25,000 miles, but...
There's never any seats for 25,000 miles.
Frustrating, isn't it? But that won't happen with the Capital One Venture Card. You can book any airline, anytime. Hey, I just said that. After all, isn't traveling hard enough?
To get the flight you want, sign up for a Venture Card at CapitalOne.com.
What's in your wallet? It's okay. I've played a pilot before.
This USL Pro broadcast on Fox Soccer is brought to you by USLSoccer.com. Scores, stats, news, and more exclusively on USLSoccer.com, the official website of United Soccer Leagues. By USLLive.com, the league's official online video channel. Check out over 100 USL Pro games on USLLive.com in 2011. By Major Beach Soccer, the original beach soccer organization. Visit MajorBeachSoccer.com to register your team today. And by Umbro, true to soccer since 1924. For more information, visit Umbro.com. This is just the beginning of a triple header of soccer here on Fox Soccer. It's Soccer Night in America later tonight as the Seattle Sounders and Vancouver Whitecaps with a long history meet for the first time in Major League Soccer. That's at 10:30 Eastern tonight, and it's live in HD. Our next broadcast of the USL Pro Game of the Week, 1 week from tonight, will be in Orlando as City hosts the Wilmington Hammerheads. Be sure to join us for that. We're just about set to kick off the hometown Rochester Rhinos against the Harrisburg City Islanders. These two teams met just a month and a day ago, and Harrisburg won that one 1-0. We'll see what happens tonight here at Salem Stadium. Ken Tomasch along with Peter Meller. And the City Islanders in white kick off and will attack from left to right here in our first half of play. And I'll knock this one long, looking for Jose Angulo, a young man we talked briefly about in the open, and we'll talk about quite a bit as this game progresses, Peter. Angulo is a terrific young player, scored a pair of goals at midweek. He's their leading scorer with 6 goals, and he's going to be going right at that Rochester back line, including that man, Neil Kitson, their goalkeeper. Kitson's goal kick here in the opening minute of play goes across midfield. Dustin Bixler got a head on that one. He's the captain, number 3 in white for the City Islanders. But here, now it's Rochester on the attack, and they'll look for Andrew Hoxie. He'll set across, it'll bounce in the area. And JT Noon cleared up to the far side. Drew Kost got a foot on that, number 3 in green, former Penn Stater for Rochester, and the ball's into touch on the far side. Quickly, we'll tell you, Neil Kitson starting in goal for Rochester. His back four are Will Traynor, Troy Roberts, Tyler Bellamy, and TJ Gore. JC Banks, Tyler Rosenlund, Drew Kost, and Tony Donatelli are the midfielders. And Andrew Hoxie and Kendall Jagdeosing up top. And Harrisburg tries to spring Angulo long on a ball out of the back, but he's marked there by Tyler Bellamy. Gets away from him, but did not keep the ball in play. We can tell you that Harrisburg starters include Phil Tuttle in goal. We'll discuss that more as we go along. Phil Tuttle started and won at midweek. He's done well, so he gets the start again tonight. See, Rochester is in green and white. Harrisburg in the white tops and the blue shorts. Steven Basso, Dustin Bixler, Andrew Welker, and Anthony Calvano are his back four. Jason Pelletier, David Schofield, JT Noon, as the three midfielders in Coach Bill Betcher's kind of a 4-3-3 lineup. Jason Hodgkin, Jose Angulo, and Brian Umbigi, the three men up front. Here's Jagdeosing, but that ball played just a little bit too far for him and scooped up easily by Phil Tuttle. Now, Peter, you were a longtime goalkeeper. If you're Phil Tuttle, you played well at the midweek. You're getting a chance here. You're playing on a big stage against a big opponent. What are his emotions like right now?
Well, I think obviously he played, you know, well in the week, and he's ready to play. You know, that's what being a pro is all about. So even though he's a young pro, and I think he's, you know, very much into it.
Phil Tuttle out of Notre Dame, just 23 years old. This is just his third game of the season. Played well in that 4-1 win against Dayton at midweek. Here's Jagdeosing having that one go off his foot. Ball will bounce around in the midfield and be settled there by David Schofield. And now it'll back once again onto the Harrisburg back line, and they'll send it back to Phil Tuttle. We're just in the opening few minutes from Salem Stadium in Rochester, New York, the 2011 debut of the USL Pro Game of the Week here on Fox Soccer. Ken Tomash and Peter Meller with you. And now here up this near side, Anthony Calvano, like that one through the midfield, but it's picked off there. And they'll work it to JC Banks here along the near side. Banks looking for Hoxie, and Hoxie got tied up with his opposite number, Calvano. Ball into touch on the near side. It'll be a throw in for the City Islanders. Harrisburg is 4-3-2 coming in. They only won four games all of last year, Peter. So this is a side in Harrisburg that looks like they're getting back to the kind of form they had in 2007 when they won the league.
Yep.
Now Harrisburg will play this one wide on the far side. Steven Basso, we'll see him push up from his left back position. Now they'll knock this one into the box, looking for Hodgkin. It'll go over his head. Banks is on him in the corner. He'll play it back out to Calvano, who's pushed up from the right side. Nice swerving ball into the box, headed up high in the air. It's going to force Neil Kitson to come outside of his comfort zone and grab that one. Talked about Harrisburg's Bill Betcher. He knows Rochester head man Bob Lilly very well. They were teammates indoors for many years. Two guys from central Pennsylvania here in Western New York tonight as the Rhinos take on the City Islanders. That ball is spun into the area and Tuttle gets his fist to it. Jagdeo Singh was there though, putting pressure on the young man early on. Now Hodgkins will play it out of the back. Through the midfield, Pelletier gets it away from a Rhino. Into space to David Schofield. Loose ball flicked on in the back heel by David Schofield. Now we'll see Brian Umbiji. Got the moves, but can the City Islanders do anything with it? Not if they give away balls in the midfield like that. Tyler Rosenlund plays it to Drew Cost, and Cost. That came at a cost to David Schofield as he went down. Cost with the tackle. Bixler gets ahead to it. Now Calvano. Settled in the midfield by Rochester. He left-footed onto left wing to Banks. Rough first touch, settles. Banks, looked like he was going to shoot, draws a crowd, goes down. We play on, much to the chagrin of the crowd. Swung into the box and cleared away by Harrisburg. What are you seeing early on, Peter?
I think that both teams are sort of feeling each other out. Both teams giving the ball away and that, so it's just a matter of settling in.
And again, Harrisburg played it midweek, so they haven't had much time to recover. Rochester at home after a long and sometimes arduous trek down to Antigua, but they got 4 points out of the two games, so Bob Lilly wasn't complaining as much. Here's Drew Cost now in the center circle. Tony Donatelli, he'll make a lot of things happen as a creative midfielder. But that left footer eludes Jagdeo Singh. And Phil Tuttle has it there. JC Banks stepped in on that one. It's cleared away. JT Noon with it now. And Noon will play it wide. Now Bixler. Goes to Calvano. Calvano again. Comes down to Angulo. Now we'll see this young man at work. Off to Umbiji. They work it back to Angulo. Ball bounces around. Left-footed shot goes high and wide. But you can see he's got some skills. He just didn't wasn't able to control that one.
No, he does, and I think, you know, the taste of being at Philadelphia, you know, for a period of time has whet his appetite.
And he and Umbiji worked pretty well together. They tried to work the 1-2 there.
Yep.
Went off the head of a defender. And so in the eighth minute, Neil Kitson will take a goal kick. Warm, humid night here in Rochester. There was rain sprinkles earlier, but they've cleared off for now. Conditions pretty good for soccer tonight. Here's Ombiji trying to race on to this one, but getting there first is TJ Gore. Kitson should have done better with that. Cost bails him out. And Jagdeo Singh comes away with the ball. Here's Kendall Jagdeo Singh. Marked tightly there by Andrew Welker. Again, they work the give and go here. It's Trainer. Now Cost will play this one into space. Into the box, Jagdeo Singh flicks it back out to Donatelli. Donatelli couldn't turn and get his hips around. And back the other way come the City Islanders. Ombiji. Another look to play it wide here. Calvano has Hodgkin as an option. Gets him. And that's cleared away by Troy Roberts, who's making his return to the lineup after a groin injury. Now it's Hoxie running into the box. Hoxie with a left footer. Saved by Tuttle. First big chance of the night. And Hodgkin trying to clear it for Harrisburg. Held in now by Rosenlund. Now Cost tracks it down in midfield for Rochester. Again, Will Trainer will push up. Send a right footer into the box. Who wants the ball? Brian Ombiji does. Now it's Pelletier. Just looking to pick out Angulo, the driving ball. It's picked off by Rochester. And now Troy Roberts. As we reach the 10-minute mark. Roberts had played every minute of every game a year ago, so having to miss a few games with that groin injury was very, very difficult for him. We'll see if he's got his fitness and is able to go the full 90 tonight or not on a warm night. He'll launch this ball long onto the right side. And again, look how many men Harrisburg has behind the ball.
Yeah. Trying to force it too a little bit, Rochester. You know, I'd like to see them be a little bit more patient.
And Banks is offside. Let's take a look at that most recent chance here, Peter. Best one of the night so far.
No, actually, good goalkeeping in terms of coming out, narrowing that near post angle. Great save.
And again, Tuttle is not a very big guy. He's not a huge keeper. Just 6'1", but did play the angles well. Here he'll launch the free kick, looking for Hodgkin, but getting ahead on it first is Will Trainer, but he knocks it into touch on the near side for a throw in. Rosenlund tried to send that one ahead. And here come the City Islanders back the other way. JT Noon. Play to the far side. Again, they'll look long, and Angulo's way offside. But if you're a forward and a goal scorer, that's going to happen, right?
Oh, yeah. I mean, you know, it's just the timing of the runs. Just got to be a little bit more patient and know when to break.
There you see Bob Lilly, USL Hall of Famer. Longtime coach in this league, won a title in 2006 with the Vancouver Whitecaps, and now in his second year here in Rochester, trying to uphold the tradition that the Rhinos have had here since 1996. And his team has had the one good chance thus far this match. Tuttle knocks that one long. Troy Roberts had a beat on it all the way as it dropped out of the sky. Drew Cost had that one stripped away from him by Pelletier. Now JT Noon. Noon with a left footer, and I don't know if Cost got a piece of that or not and deflected it. Apparently not. Out for a goal kick. Now Kitson's goal kick. Across midfield, Bixler draws a bead on that. And it actually goes out off Andrew Hoxie. Let's take a look at the captain. Launch balls out of the back and try to spring either on BG or Angulo. So Bill Betcher's strategy pretty obvious from the get-go.
Yep, trying to use both their speed.
Kitson sends a low liner that's easy pickings for the back line of Harrisburg. Noon now. Basso, who again will venture forward. And Ombiji gives him the return ball. Tried to send that one across, and it's out off a defender, Bellamy, for a deep throw in for Harrisburg in the 15th minute. Basso's throw finds Angulo. And Angulo finds himself wrapped up in those green shirts. Still squirts one across, and Roberts clears. This young man, Jose Angulo, turned pro out of high school, Jersey City St. Anthony's, Claudio Reyna's alma mater. Big things were expected of him. Hasn't quite gone, his pro career hasn't quite gone as he expected, but it's starting to come into form now.
Yeah, it is. And, you know, as I said earlier, I think getting a taste of that next level too, you know, and having to come back down, he knows what it's about.
And he's got six goals on the season. And Jagdeo Singh is onside. He got in behind the defense, takes a shot, but he took it maybe a little bit before he wanted to, and it was easy pickings for Phil Tuttle. But still a good chance to spring him, and a momentary lapse by that Harrisburg defense. Kendall Jagdeo Singh is a speedy player. You got to keep your eye on him at all times. That'll go out deep. We're in the 16th minute, Salem Stadium in Rochester, New York. USL Pro Game of the Week. First of 10 telecasts here in the regular season. Ken Tomash and Peter Miller with you. It's the Harrisburg City Islanders in white trying to clear this one out of their own box. And the homestanding Rhinos of Rochester in green, who win their first corner of the match. And they may be looking for that young man, Andrew Hoxie, at the end of this corner kick. Let's see. Donatelli is a bender to the far post, and it's cleared away by the Harrisburg defense. Drew Cost now switches it way to the far side. Donatelli in a crowd. Now Gore finds Donatelli again, thinks better of the cross, and it's knocked out again by Harrisburg. So another throw in for Rochester. Again, they'll look for Hoxie in the box. Before Jagdeo Singh can get there, now he gets it back. Look, Hoxie pushes it forward, and Tuttle comes out just outside his six to take that one right off the boot of Kendall Jagdeo Singh. Nice little touch by Hoxie.
Yeah, Tuttle reading the situation well, coming off his line quickly and smothering. Great goalkeeping again.
This portion of the match brought to you by USLsoccer.com. Scores, stats, news, and more exclusively on USLsoccer.com, the official website of United Soccer Leagues.
Thanks to Breathe Yoga, the official yoga studio of your Rhinos.
Jason Hotchkin.
Yoga to improve their recovery time to prevent injury and increase flexibility. Visit breatheyoga.com.
Bob Lilly's team looking for a little better form than he thinks they displayed in the early season. They are 2-0-2 at home, but he would like to see a bit more for them. They got a tie in Antigua on Sunday in dramatic fashion. And glad to have Troy Roberts back after a groin injury suffered more than a month ago, or actually a few weeks ago, sorry. There's Bill Betcher. Led Harrisburg to the 2007 league championship, and they were a quarterfinalist in the U.S. Open Cup a year ago. Both of these teams will play in the Open Cup on Tuesday. Harrisburg's going to host Reading, and Rochester will host Phoenix SC out of the Philadelphia area as the U.S. Open Cup gets going on Tuesday. 50-50 ball, and thought he got away with it. Anthony Calvano thought he got away with the shove. He did not. Jason White is the man in the middle tonight. And it's a free kick here for Rochester. Trainer, instead of serving it into the box, will play it here on the left wing to JC Banks. And it'll be touched out of play by Harrisburg. Now they get a throw. Now it's Drew Cost. Pushes that one forward to Hoxie. Stolen away by Pelletier. Nice one-touch passing through the midfield by Harrisburg, and Angulo offside again. With his speed, though, if he can just time that run right, all you need is one.
Yeah, I mean, it's just, again, as I said earlier, being patient and just, you know, looking along that line and knowing when to break. Again, a little too early there.
Now Trainer here on the near side in the 20th minute. And Roberts will go overland. And Hoxie is offside. And Welker will play it back to Tuttle. The ball's forever in the air with a lot of backspin. Comes down to JC Banks. Trainer will one touch it forward. Rosenlund is onside. Sends it across, and Tuttle grabs that one about 2 yards off his line.
That's a great change of play ball, too, from Tuttle, going from left to right.
Now, scrap for it in the midfield. Angulo had it for just a moment. And now Rochester has to hustle and clear that ball out of play. Let's take a look at that chance, Peter. Rosenlund keeps it in before it goes off the byline.
Very good catch, and then a great distribution out opposite way.
Good decision making by the young man from Notre Dame. You'd figure he's a smart guy, right?
You would think so.
Now, Drew Cost has come over to the bench here, and Bob Lilly's giving him some instructions. And so at the moment, Rochester down to just 10 men, but Drew Cost gets back into the fray. And we're going to have a throw in for his side on the far side of the field. TJ Gore will take it again. Into Donatelli. Too strong on the first touch, and the City Islanders have it back. Mbiji up to Angulo. Tries to go right back, and it's spun the other way and out of play, but off a defender. Quick throw in by the City Islanders. Got Hotchkin open here on the near side, and find him. And Calvano would make an overlapping run, but Hotchkin instead reverses it the other way, and that one sailed away on him before Mbiji could get to it. And Hotchkin none too pleased with himself. At 33, as of last Sunday, Jason Hotchkin is the oldest of the City Islanders, who averaged just 25 years old. And you might expect to see that at this level, Peter. You see players, some of these players are in their first professional season. There are a few veterans, but it's a young team Harrisburg has. Now Mbiji finds the ball back at his feet. Circulates out of traffic, now gets it back. As the sun peeks out here, first time in a while. Troy Roberts again with some pressure from Hotchkin. Back to Rosenlund. Will Traynor now here on the near side. Threads a beautiful ball to Jagdeo Singh. Now it's Banks. Good positioning by Welker to shield him away from the ball excellent, and let his keeper come out.
Excellent defending, you know, just enough to keep away from the goal.
Andrew Welker. Well done by, we talk about young players. Welker is just 21 years old. He's got the ball at his feet now, and Kendall Jagdeo Singh in front of him, but he plays it back to Phil Tuttle. Now Steven Basso. He'll left put it up looking for Ambiji. Rochester defense got there first. JT Noon has it back now. Now Ambiji, who's dropped back to receive that one. Finds Calvano. And they know from the last meeting, and they've seen Ambiji, so they're not letting him get a lot of space if they can avoid it.
No, work rate is absolutely tremendous. He's all over the field.
He's got the ball now, pokes that one forward. Schofield sends that one across the box, but nobody was there. And Gulo was making a run directly up the middle. And so Neil Kitson sits it here to Rosenlund. Now Banks, who's drifted into the center of midfield, goes wide to the far side to TJ Gore. Donatelli now. More than halfway through this first half, no score. Rochester with a few chances, but their defense has been equal to the task as Harrisburg. Play this one into space for Hoxie. Long loping strides, but again, Welker there. Johnny on the spot. And Gulo got tied up in midfield, and Jason White alertly waited until play was broken up before calling the foul there. Tyler Bellamy. Now Pelletier slides that free kick upwards to JT Noon. And now he'll get it back. 26th minute. As again, they find Hotchkin here on the right side. Hotchkin with Will Traynor on him, goes to the turf. Harrisburg still controlling though. Pelletier. Go back to Dustin Bixler in the center circle. Here's Angulo. Slides that one forward looking for Ambiji, and Ambiji is all over Tyler Bellamy.
Getting up proteins following an intense workout will help in the muscle recovery process.
Again, they look for Jagdeo Singh, but again, Andrew Welker is there to get ahead on that one. Welker and Jagdeo Singh collided. Jagdeo Singh goes down, holding his head, and Welker holding his eye. Let's take a look, see what happened. 50-50 ball?
Yeah, I think it's just a 50-50 ball, and just unfortunate they both collide. Both going for the ball fairly.
May have been Jagdeo Singh's head that hit Welker in the eye, but Welker is up and Jagdeo Singh is not. Well, he's rubbing that forehead. All right, Welker's ready to go, but Jagdeo Singh is not. Now he's up. Athletic trainer Dave DePasquale having a look. Good chance for the City Islanders to get some water, for both the squads to get some water, actually, on a, as we told you, a warm, humid evening. Now they're going to send both players just off to the fourth official. Check back in. May not feel it now, but he will in the morning. And they're both okay. All right, back to action now, 29th minute. It's Phil Tuttle knocks this one long. Headed back the other way by Trainer for Rochester. JC Banks now. Cost to Donatelli in the midfield. Tried to left that, put that one through, but Mbeji blocked it. Tried to steal it away from him. Harrisburg has it back. Mbeji now draws a crowd, drops it back to Stephen Basso. Oh, almost a dangerous giveaway there. Tuttle there to clean it up. And Phil Tuttle has it again. Andrew Welker. Now a little bit of space here for Dune. Angulo with a lot of space for the first time tonight. Trying to cut it back inside. Ball skills. Off to Mbeji on left wing. Now Basso will swerve that one across. Finally cleared by Banks. Held in here now by Calvano for Harrisburg. We've reached the 30-minute mark. And it looked like Harrisburg was building up to maybe their first real chance of the first half. Let's take a look at it.
Yeah, I mean, that's a great ball in. Very difficult for the keeper to decide whether to come or not because you've got defenders in there. Great ball in. I'm lucky.
This portion of the match brought to you by USLLive.com, the league's official online video channel. Check out over 100 USL Pro games on USLLive.com in 2011. So now the feeling out process should be pretty much over. More than a half hour into this match between the Harrisburg City Islanders in white and the Rochester Rhinos in green. Harrisburg looking for their fourth straight win. And we told you, either team who's able to win tonight will move into first place in the National Division. Now they spring Rosenlund, who's come out of the midfield, but he is offside. Mbeji now. This game seems to have been played quite a bit, Peter,
almost
in the midfield,
almost
exclusively.
Well,
yeah. And the far side.
On the far side, yeah. They've not really used the right side very much, Harrisburg.
Rochester, meanwhile, they're kind of a right-sided team. We've seen quite a bit this season.
Yeah, yeah. And also, the back four's, you know, done a very good job in holding you know, the two danger men up front from Harrisburg.
There's Hoxie. That one knocked back to midfield. And the play in the midfield has been quite physical, hasn't it?
Very physical, yeah. And I'd like to, you know, see sort of settle down a little bit more and knock the ball around just a little more in their build-up. But, you know, a lot of pressure on the ball, which creates physical.
There's been bodies flying around quite a bit. Jason White hasn't had to discipline any players yet to this point. Just had a talk with a couple of them there. 33rd minute as that one goes into the box and Angulo won't get there before it's over the byline. There you see Anthony Calvano, a great story. Been a mainstay at right back for this Harrisburg team for many a year, never comes out. He was playing club soccer at Penn State when he was noticed by varsity team. Been playing for the Nittany Lions, and now he's here from Harrisburg.
Back every time.
He looks like he likes to get forward, too.
That he does. And Dustin Bixler will head that one back to his keeper. And Kendall Jagdeosingh, who was involved in that head-to-head collision a few minutes ago. Looks none the worse for wear. That one's knocked long and over the head of Angulo. Now here's Calvano. Noon goes back to his captain, Bixler. Nice tackle by Hoxie to win the ball away. Showing some good foot skills for a big man. Slides it through to Jagdeosingh. His first touch betrays him, though. J.C. Banks got all ball, despite what Jason Pelletier thinks. And Rosenlund will switch it to the far side. Foot race there, and Basso gets there first for Harrisburg to Umbiji. He's got some options in front of him. He's got Schofield, finds him. Tried to back heel it back to Umbiji. Taken away by the Rhinos. TJ Gore lost it in midfield. Now they'll try that right side. Send it in the box. Jagdeosingh over his head. JC Banks. Donatelli. Nice work there by Bixler. Shot high and over the bar. TJ Gore. Just 22, but already a veteran of Rochester soccer. Good work there by Bixler to force him to get rid of that ball.
Yeah. The shot needed to get over the top of it a little bit, keep it the ball down.
That one drops over the head of Angulo and Roberts. And Umbiji's offside. Umbiji scored some big goals over the years for Harrisburg, including one in the 2007 championship match. He had two at midweek against Dayton. We're still looking for our first goal of this match. Again, the Rhinos in green and the City Islanders in white. Here's Jagdeosingh again. Turf Monster may have gotten him there. Banks now with a nice spin move to get across Welker. Sets up Donatelli, and his left footer goes high into the stands. Best chance of the night for either team.
I don't think he'll be happy with that, knowing he's a left footer.
Here it is again. Nice build-up.
Great build-up. Nice ball in. Again, just leaning backwards on the execution.
So we're in the 37th minute now. Approaching halftime, but Phil Tuttle kept a clean sheet to this point. Gore got ahead on that one. But Angulo now drawing a crowd. Bounces that one across. It's going to go off a defender and maybe the first corner kick of the evening for the City Islanders. Good work there by Mr. Angulo.
Come on, boys. Come on. Nothing. Now
Jason Hotchkin will go to the far side flag. And Neil Kitson will have a little bit of the sun to his left. This outswinger is low. Bounces through the box. Collected here by Schofield, who tried to send it in again. And leaping high to make the grab was Neil Kitson. And with a man down in his own box, Kitson clears it into touch on the near side. See who's down. It's Tyler Bellamy. One of the new Rhinos, just 22 years old, out of St. Bonaventure University. And the way he's holding his head, maybe there was one of those collisions in the box that would be so common on a play like that. He's getting an up-close and personal look at the artificial surface here at Salem Stadium, which just over a week ago celebrated its fifth anniversary. Rhinos used to play about a half mile away at Frontier Field. They've got a lovely facility here. And now the sun's come out. It's a pretty decent evening for soccer. It's not quite as, doesn't feel quite as hot and humid as it was. Good crowd on hand, enjoying a night of Rhino soccer. Big sports weekend here in Rochester, and they've got a jazz festival going on. And tomorrow night, the stadium will host Western New York Flash against the Philadelphia Independents in women's professional soccer, which you can see right here on Fox Soccer. In fact, the Independents is here somewhere. See if we can find them. They're supposed to come to the match tonight. And that may have drawn blood on Tyler Bellamy. A collision over the right eye, apparently. Fans behind Phil Tuttle's goal at the other end. Some wearing the red, white, and blue. Of course, the U.S. against Panama in the Gold Cup comes up immediately after our game.
This is James Cannon Studios. Have a wedding or a special event coming up? Visit jamescannonstudios.com today to have your event captured in the most tasteful fashion.
I hope that Tyler Bellamy doesn't require anything more than a little bit of attention, maybe hopefully not stitches or anything. So the last several minutes here, the first half, we've had a couple of player collisions and injuries. And it looks like Rich Costanzo is warming up, and so Tyler Bellamy may be done. To the throw-in. Back into Neil Kitson. And it does look like we will see Rich Costanzo entering the match for Tyler Bellamy. Right now, the Rhinos are a man down. That one will bounce all the way to the top of Phil Tuttle's 18.
Okay, fans, please turn your attention to the scoreboard.
Now Tuttle knocks it long. Umbiji trying to get there, but Troy Roberts outleaped him for it. Schofield slipped on the ball. Oh, Hoxie went down pretty soft there, and Jason White wasn't buying it. 42nd minute now.
Come on up whenever you're ready. Just hold that when they step. Oh, he's over.
Again, they have Calvano here. And now you, with Rochester even temporarily down a man, maybe a chance for Harrisburg.
Yep, you know, get players forward and hope that we can get that goal just before halftime.
As long as they keep the ball in play, Costanzo's not going to be able to enter. Here's Angulo, left-footed shot. Right to Neil Kitson. And the crowd here is screaming at Jason White to let Rich Costanzo into the match. So Rochester down a man temporarily as Tyler Bellamy took a knock in the head, and he's out of the match to be replaced by Rich Costanzo at the next opportunity. And Harrisburg would just assume that opportunity never arise. Pelletier now, as Rochester puts the pressure on now. JT Noon. Pelletier to Hotchkin. They'll chip that left footer forward. And Umbiji. Now they're gonna have the foul called there. Umbiji sent his man down. And now we'll see the sub. 43rd minute, and the sarcastic applause As Rich Costanzo comes in. 24-year-old defender. Played for Rochester last year. And now as we approach halftime. Costanzo started the last few matches for Bob Lilly. Now he'll come off the bench approaching halftime, replacing the injured Tyler Bellamy. And Costanzo has the ball now. And Banks was offside. And Peter, with neither team able really to get any cohesion through the midfield, these long balls, I think, is something we're going to continue to see until somebody finds a way to beat the offside.
Yeah, you know, I'd like to see Harrisburg play a little bit more, as you say, through the midfield, you know, because everything that they're knocking up long is getting, you know, won by Roberts and company. So I'd like to see a little bit more possession in midfield patience.
Tuttle knocks that one out to midfield. As we approach 45 minutes played, Calvano knocks that one long. Beachy trying to get there, but Trainer got there first. Now it's Costanzo. Angulo opportunistic, but loses it to Cost. And Hoxie's offside, and the crowd here does not like that one. Crowd that's hungry for a goal hates to see a chance like that go away. We've got 3 minutes of stoppage time after all of that. So we're in first half stoppage time, still looking for our first goal. It's the Harrisburg City Islanders in white attacking from left to right against the Rochester Rhinos in green. Here's Umbeji now, drifted here to the near side. Basso finds Noon, and that one's too long again. Kitson sends this one long. Slip head by Hoxie. Jagdeo Singh trying to get there, but Captain Dustin Bixler gets there first for Harrisburg. Deep throw in now for the Rhinos. More than a minute into stoppage time. Off the throw in now. Banks has it back. Costanzo, looks like he was thinking of shooting. Falls in the box and cleared away. Roberts got the better of Angulo on that challenge. More than halfway through our 3 minutes of stoppage time. Can either team get something here in the scant seconds that remain? Pelletier to Noon. Well, it's Hotchkin, rather. To Basso. Pushed up from left back. Now Pelletier pushes it to Basso again.
Why?
Scoot this one across. Angulo is there. Charlie Roberts kind of fell a little bit awkwardly, but effectively as it kept the ball out of the net.
Why?
Top of the box, chested down by Cost. A little over 30 seconds remaining in the first half as Kendall Jagdeasingh tracks this one down, 1v1 with Bixler. Oh, gets around him.
Hey, wait.
Well, J.C. Banks was waiting to pounce at the edge of the 18, but it's cleared alertly by the Harrisburg defense. Probably the last chance here of the first half. Oh my gosh. Umbeji tried to just knock that one out of play, and he put it right into the face of J.C. Banks. And that's the end of the first half. Take a look at this. This is wrong place, wrong time for J.C. Banks. So he's looking to clear it. Hits him right in the face.
Can't get out of the way.
Well, that's the end of the first half of play. No goals, but certainly some drama here as the Harrisburg City Islanders and the Rochester Rhinos will play 45 more minutes to try to decide this one. It's the first USL Pro game of the week for 2011 from Salem Stadium in Rochester. We'll be back after this with our halftime show. Don't go away.
Still at the office? Man, you need a vacay. Don't have to go far for fun. Ride a dune buggy or scuba diving? Pow! I make it easy. You make it fun. So many super destinations. Such low rates.
Remember, a good agent is prepared for any situation.
Roger that.
Gee, that was born prepared.
Uh-oh, that ain't good.
You can't always be prepared. That's why State Farm is here for you.
Now that's an undercover agent.
State Farm agents, always looking out for you. Disney Pixar's Cars 2, only in theaters.
Find out why X-Men First Class is the best reviewed movie of the summer.
How's that for a magic trick?
Best I've ever seen.
X-Men First Class, certified fresh, rated PG-13.
What can you tell me about Shell nitrogen-enriched gasoline?
They clean up gunk left by lower-quality gasoline.
Then they act as a protective barrier that shields and protects engines against performance-rotting gunk.
You really are experts.
So DiGiorno comes with boneless wings now?
Oh, yeah, great wings.
So why did you call?
Just want to give you your menus back. Fridge magnet and two unused coupons. Okay?
New DiGiorno pizza and boneless wings. It's not delivery, it's DiGiorno pizza and wings.
FoxSoccer.com, the world's leading soccer site, just got better. Now featuring exclusive match highlights from the Barclays Premier League, UEFA Champions League, and more. From Rooney and the Red Devils to Messi and Barcelona. Catch the best plays from each game online, only on FoxSoccer.com.
WPS is on Fox Soccer. The Western New York Flash take on the Philadelphia Independence. Live tomorrow, presented by Puma.
Witness the next chapter of an eternal rivalry. The 2011 State of Origin Series. Queensland, New South Wales, in an all-out war. Live exclusively on Fox Soccer. Landon Donovan.
Brilliant, beautiful football.
Gold Cup this month. Live on Fox Soccer. Presented by Chevy.
FSC in HD.
Hope you are enjoying the first part of our triple header. Don't forget, still to come, the U.S. national team looking to further control Group C as they take on Panama in the Gold Cup action. And we end the night with the Pacific Northwest Derby, the Seattle Sounders taking on the Vancouver Whitecaps in their first ever MLS meeting. Enjoy the rest of the Rochester Rhinos, Harrisburg City Islanders match.
Welcome back to Salem Stadium in Rochester, New York, everybody. At the half, the Rochester Rhinos and Harrisburg City Islanders are scoreless. Ken Tomash and Peter Meller with you from Western New York. You know, United Soccer Leagues is celebrating its 25th anniversary this year with over 100 senior franchises and 500 youth teams in the United States, Canada, and the Caribbean, the largest system of elite-level soccer leagues in North America. And while USL Pro is the strongest, most sophisticated, and most experienced North American men's professional soccer league below MLS on and off the field, it is far from the only action on the field in USL this year. Here's a look at everything that's going on in United Soccer Leagues in 2011. USL Pro is a national league featuring a regional competition model to enhance and build natural rivalries. The 2011 USL Pro alignment is comprised of two divisions, the American and the National. Antigua, Charleston, Charlotte, Orlando, Richmond, and Wilmington make up the American division, while Dayton, FC New York, Harrisburg, Los Angeles, Pittsburgh, and Rochester play in the National division. Blending a perfect mix of long-standing USL Pro clubs and teams new to the league, USL Pro has never been stronger.
I could say that the teams have exceeded my expectations that we've played. You know, all talented in different ways, very good individual players for sure, athletic. So what I've seen so far and what I've watched on USL Live, and then speaking to some of the coaches that have been in the league for a long time, they're comfortable with the level being better than it's been. So, you know, who am I to judge better than them? So I think that we're in a pretty tough league right now.
The Premier Development League is the top U23 men's league in North America, featuring 64 teams across the United States, Canada, and the Caribbean. The PDL offers elite collegiate players the chance to play at a higher level of competition while maintaining their university eligibility. In 2011, 8 of the first 10 players selected in the MLS Super Draft had played in the PDL. USL's top level of women's soccer in the United States and Canada is the W League, the first and longest standing women's league in North America. 27 teams will vie for the W League title, hosted by the Seattle Sounders women in 2011. Before getting to the W League or the Premier Development League, many players develop their games in the USL's Super Y and Super 20 leagues. While the Super Y League continues to grow at an incredible pace, the Super 20 League continues to be the only U20 men's and women's North American amateur league. Great moments, great memories over the years, and this year we'll bring you all the passion, excitement, and tradition of United Soccer League's USL Pro, championships in the W League and PDL. It's all summer long here on Fox Soccer. Including our next telecast 1 week from tonight will be in Orlando at the Citrus Bowl as Orlando City, which saw its 11-match unbeaten streak come to an end last night as Antigua Barracuda beat them 2-1. They'll be hosting the Wilmington Hammerheads. Join us next week on Fox Soccer. That is a 7:30 p.m. Eastern time kickoff. We'll be back with highlights and stats after this. Don't go away. The Rhinos and City Islanders are scoreless, but we've got more for you from Salem Stadium right after this.
The legendary New York Cosmos are back, and to mark the club's rebirth, Umbro has applied its celebrated football tailoring ethos to the brand new 2011 collection. Anthem jacket, Cosmos tees, New York Cosmos jersey, 1976-1977 home jersey. For the complete New York Cosmos line, go to soccer.com/Umbro.
X-Men First Class is the best reviewed movie of the summer.
How's that for a magic trick?
Best I've ever seen.
X-Men First Class, certified fresh, rated PG-13.
The world's favorite pastime comes to America in search of gold.
Donovan!
Team USA goes head to head against the best in CONCACAF. Gold Cup. Guadalupe versus USA, live Tuesday, only on Fox Soccer, presented by Chevy.
Soccer night in America. It's a Northwestern rivalry as the Sounders look to dominate the Whitecaps. Live tonight on Fox Soccer. Fox Soccer Plus has over 130 exclusive Barclays Premier League games, 70 UEFA Champions League matches, and the world's best rugby competitions. Call 1-877-810-KICK or go to foxsoccerplus.com today.
Milito, Milito, la conclusione. Cross, choice is his, it is a shot.
WPS is on Fox Soccer. The Western New York Flash take on the Philadelphia Independents. Live tomorrow, presented by Puma.
Witness the next chapter
of an eternal rivalry. The 2011 State of Origin Series. Queensland, New South Wales, in an all-out war. Live, exclusively on Fox Soccer.
The broadcast of this match is authorized by the United Soccer Leagues. Any rebroadcast, retransmission, or other use of any image, sound, account, or description without the express written permission of USL is strictly prohibited. Tonight's match was produced for the USL by Cultural Global Media Incorporated. We're at Salem Stadium in Rochester, New York, and we're 45 minutes through our first USL Pro Game of the Week telecast here. Ken Tomasz along with Peter Miller. Peter, we haven't seen any goals in the first half. We did see some rough and tumble action. What would you really like to see each of these teams do in the second half that they haven't done in the first half?
Well, I'd like to see Harrisburg sort of be a little bit more patient. I think they're playing too many long balls, you know, up to Anguillo, and I think they just need to calm that down, play through the midfield a little bit more, and then try and spring them. They've been caught offside a few times up top. And Rochester, I think they're doing very well. I think overall, you know, they've sort of really caused some problems. They've got in behind a couple of times, but Tuttle in the goal for Harrisburg has come up big. So be interesting to see.
Right, let's take a look at some of the first half highlights. Rochester's had more chances, but neither team's been able to find the back of the net. Early on, though, it was Jose Angulo, who we've talked about, a little bouncing ball, and he puts it high and wide. Now it's Hoxie. We've had a couple of chances, but here's where Tuttle does well.
Yeah, he comes out well, you know, he stands up and then obviously has to go down at the last minute.
And again, Jagdeo Singh, this was latest, Tony Donatelli pushed that one forward, looking for Jagdeo Singh, and Tuttle a little upset with his defenders, but yeah. He has kept a clean sheet to this point. You see just 7 shots on goal between the two teams in the first half, each keeper with a pair of saves, and only 4 fouls called in the Peter. It seems like it's been a little bit more physical than that, has it really?
Yeah, it does, but I think a lot of the confrontations have been fair.
That's right. We have seen a couple players get knocked to the turf. We've seen Tyler Bellamy have to leave the game because of an injury. We'll see what the second half has in store for us here from Salem Stadium in Rochester, New York. The second half is coming up. We're scoreless between the Rhinos and City Islanders. Don't go away.
The legendary New York Cosmos are back. And to mark the club's rebirth, Umbro has applied its celebrated football tailoring ethos to the brand new 2011 collection. Anthem jacket, Cosmos tees, New York Cosmos jersey, 1976-1977 home jersey. For the complete New York Cosmos line, go to soccer.com/Umbro.
I know one thing about marketing. The more logos you put in one place, the better.
Having something unique is better.
Check it out.
The Shell Nitrogen Enriched Cleaning System acts as a barrier to help protect against performance-robbing gunk.
Mm-hmm. He's good.
Think you're stuck paying high auto insurance rates because of your driving record? Then now is the time to change the game. Just go to thegeneral.com or call us for a super fast quote. All it takes is a couple of minutes. You'll get a great low rate, low monthly payment, and a down payment as low as $59. You'll also get instant proof of insurance.
Show off. For a great low rate you can get online, go to the General and save some time.
Still at the office? Man, you need a vacay. Don't have to go far for fun. Ride a dune buggy or scuba diving? Pow! I make it easy. You make it fun. So many super destinations, such low rates.
The world's favorite pastime comes to America in search of gold. With goals from Altidore and Dempsey against Canada. Next up, the States take on Panama. Gold Cup. Live tonight, only on Fox Soccer. Presented by Chevy.
Soccer night in America. It's a Northwestern rivalry as the Sounders look to dominate the Whitecaps.
live tonight on Fox Soccer. WPS is on Fox Soccer. The Western New York Flash take on the Philadelphia Independents. Live tomorrow, presented by Puma.
Witness the next chapter of an eternal rivalry. The 2011 State of Origin Series. Queensland, New South Wales, in an all-out war. Live exclusively on Fox Soccer.
This USL Pro broadcast on Fox Soccer is brought to you by USLsoccer.com. Scores, stats, news, and more exclusively on USLsoccer.com, the official website of United Soccer Leagues. By USLlive.com, the league's official online video channel. Check out over 100 USL Pro games on USLlive.com in 2011. By Major Beach Soccer, the original beach soccer organization. Visit MajorBeachSoccer.com to register your team today. And by Umbro, true to soccer since 1924. For more information, visit umbro.com. Lots of soccer coming up here on Fox Soccer. Right after our game, it's the U.S. against Panama in the Gold Cup. Group stage continues as the Stars and Stripes look to clinch a berth in the quarterfinals. And then on Tuesday, they'll be in Kansas City, Kansas at Livestrong Sporting Park to take on Guadeloupe. It's all coming up here, the excitement of the Gold Cup and the U.S. men's national team. All this week on Fox Soccer. Here's Bill Betcher's gone to his bench and inserted young Saini Touré to give them a little bit more up front. What do you like about Saini Touré, Peter?
Well, I think, you know, the fact that they need to mix it up a little bit because they became very predictable, you know, with Angulo and Abiji. So I think this will be interesting to see if he can make the difference.
Saini Touré comes into the match replacing Jason Hodgkin, and that appears to be our only change to start the second half. Touré is a, here's Jack Diasing with the first chance. It's heading towards the goal and cleared away by Dustin Bixler. Easy as you please. He looked like he waited until the very last second to just calmly clear that one off the goal line. Jack Diasing shows the speed, huh?
Very, very much so, and good covering by the defender there. Great, great cover.
Did Tuttle get a piece of that? Couldn't tell for certain. In any case, Saini Touré, number 20, who's come into the match for Harrisburg, is a 21-year-old Gambian. That one's sent to the far post, almost dangerous, and that was a tough play there for Phil Tuttle as he is now battling that setting sun. And it looked for a second as if he lost track of the ball. So he's got the sun field here in the second half. You can tell by the shadows which way the sun is pointing. And so we'll see if that becomes a factor here in the second half. The setting sun, maybe in his eyes. Bob Lilly told us before the match that in their two-game set in Antigua, the sun set very early there, so they didn't have to worry about Sunfield so much, but here, as we near the equinox, the sun stays up in the sky for quite a while. Jack Diasing, who has had a couple of collisions so far in this game, goes down again, but Jason White, again, not willing to go to his book. He will whistle a free kick here. Bixler avoids the book. Kendall Jack Diasing is going to need some Advil. Free kick now as Troy Roberts has come up. Just underway in the second half. So looking for our first goal. Rochester's had a couple of chances here in the early going. Hoxie touches that one out to Cost. Shoulder to shoulder challenge there by Basso. And Mbiji has that one go past Pelletier. And while Rosalind was sitting there admiring it, Saini Touré came in and picked his pocket. Pelletier now in the center circle. Left puts it forward. Dangerous play there and forces Neil Kitson into an awkward clearance.
Now Rich Costanzo on it left back on the far side. We saw him come in late in the first half, replacing Tyler Bellamy, who took a knock over one eye late in the half. We'll see if this game starts to open up here. A little more open play here in the opening couple of minutes.
Yeah, it's started to open up, and Tony's got forward a couple of times and caused some problems. So.
That time Jagdeo Singh was offside. Tried to get the ball there to the man you just saw, Andrew Hoxie. And we'll see what Tony Donatelli can do. Trying to create something in the midfield for Rochester. So here come the City Islanders. Out of the back, they're attacking from right to left here in the second half. Wearing white, Rochester in green. Jose Angulo pushes it into the midfield. First touch by Toure. And Costanzo, the nice defensive play there, but Welker there to keep it in the clutches of the City Islanders. Now he'll switch it here, but Jagdeo Singh intercepts in the center circle. Deft touch. He's got his man making an overlapping run. Square ball, probably a poor decision there. Basso will left foot that one forward. Comes to Cost. Toure gets ahead on that one. And the Rhinos will start again from the back with Troy Roberts. There's Gore. Hoxie was trying to post up there. One went off Schofield. Well done by Toure. He got knocked off the ball. Presence to get it back. But there he's knocked off the ball again. He's tall, but a little bit slight. Saini Toure.
Well done, big back in. Kelly with the stick. Well!
This portion of the match brought to you by Umbro. True to soccer since 1924. For more information, visit umbro.com. Now here's Schofield. Basso slides that one through, but it's cleared away by Will Traynor of Rochester. Nice move there. And Jagdeo Singh is off to the races. He's got Hoxie as an option. And again, Welker, great defensive work.
Yeah, very good, just using his body and sort of not diving in. Very good, solid defending.
Andrew Welker, one of the five local players on this Harrisburg roster. We've got five guys from the Harrisburg area playing on their pro team. Welker is from Mechanicsburg, Cumberland Valley High, and played at Seton Hall. And he's been quite the find for Bill Betcher. He's done yeoman's work tonight with a couple of great defensive plays. Tyler Bellamy is walking back on, but he's in street clothes and he's got a patch over his right eye. And now finally we see Jason White, and he's having a discussion with Brian Ombigi. And I wonder if Jason White's book is like a library book and somebody else checked it out. He's getting it done with talking to these players today, managing the game that way. Not throwing cards around. That can be effective as well.
Yeah, players like that type of a referee, providing he's still refereeing within the laws of the game.
Well, as long as things don't get much more physical. Here's Schofield now. Leaves it for Ombigi. Donatelli came up from behind him. Angulo is here and his shot is wide. Flag was up anyway. Angulo has been getting himself into position. He's had a couple of chances.
Yeah, he has, yeah. I think since he brought on Tony as well, it seems to be a little bit more about the attack. So I think there's a goal in them, to be honest.
Certainly hope so, because if someone can win this match, they'll move into first place. If Rochester wins, they will be in undisputed first place over Idle Los Angeles. If Rochester is not able to win and Harrisburg does, the City Islanders will be tied for the top on points. And BG got fouled there. Meanwhile, Orlando City leads the American division, but that gap closed a bit last night when second place Antigua, Barracuda FC, beat them 2-1 at the Citrus Bowl. That's where we'll be a week from tonight for our second telecast as the Wilmington Hammerheads come to Orlando. Rich Costanzo cleared that one out of the back towards midfield, but Harrisburg tracks it down. His ball poked forward, and Angulo, as he has most of the night, draws a crowd, but they give up the corner. Second one of the night for Harrisburg. This is something neither team has been able to take much advantage of, is there haven't been many set pieces.
Right, yeah. It's those games you get, sometimes very, very few. But you might find that might end up being the game.
Pelletier on the near side flag. Sends it far post, and again. Good goalkeeping there by Neil Kitson as he leaps up high.
Would you like your business to run more efficiently? Icon Solutions can help you streamline your document workflow and control your costs.
Kitson has that one. Bounce onto the back line. Now it's Welker. Looking for Schofield. It'll bounce around, be taken away by Rich Costanzo.
It's IKON.com.
Basso heads that one into the center circle. Again, one touch passing. Here's Angulo trying to get around his man Gore. And Gore will just shepherd it back to his keeper Kitson. High in the air, going to be a 50-50 ball here. Jagdia Singh trying to step inside. Drops to JT Noon. 56th minute, scoreless here at Salem Stadium in Rochester, New York. On the first USL Pro Game of the Week telecast here on Fox Soccer, Ken Tomash and Peter Meller with you. From Western New York, Husseini Touré was a halftime substitute. Stolen away by Gore. City Islanders have it back. Basso, play it back. It's Dustin Bixler, who's got the defensive play of this match with clearance off the line early in the second half. It's kept this match scoreless. Now, Noon again. Took pressure from Rosenlund. And now it's Rosenlund who'll come up with this loose ball in midfield for Rochester. Back to Troy Roberts. And that'll be knocked out of play here on the near side for a throw-in. And we're going to see our second Rochester sub and potentially a third. But first, it's going to be Alfonso Modigalvan, who will come in for Tony Donatelli.
Rochester Rhinos. Entering the game is number 5, Alfonso Modigalvan. Replacing number 21, Tony Donatelli. Substitution.
Modigalvan is one of numerous players in this game who played in the Premier Development League. They are all over the field here tonight. You can just look around on both of these squads and see tons of players who played in that league when they were younger. Here's Ombiji. And it's out for a corner. Modigalvan's first touch is the one that sent it over the line. Another corner kick here, and again, it's Jason Pelletier who'll take it. Could this be the first break of this match in the 58th minute? Scoreless as Pelletier rams it to the near post, and Banks sends it up into the stands. We'll do it again.
Got to beat those first defenders on those corner kicks. Got to get the ball over the head.
Banks was the first defender there and cleared it easily. So Pelletier will try it again. Kitson sets his defense. He did get it over and Kitson punches it clear. Foot race for it here. Pelletier has it back, sends a left footer, takes a deflection. Come here to the near side. And Jagdeo Singh has had his shirt tugged there by Stephen Basso. Quickly off the free kick. And Rosenlund was offside. You saw that coming a mile away.
This substitution for Rochester Rhinos.
Bob Lilly's going to go to his bench again.
Is number 13, Cuevas Kirk.
Cuevas Kirk will come in for TJ Gore in the 59th minute.
Substitution in the 59th minute.
What does Cuevas Kirk bring to the game, Peter?
I think he brings speed, getting forward. Cuevas was actually in the under-17 residency program way back when with us, and we actually played him as an attacker on the right side, and very, very quick, very capable.
Way back when, he's 23 years old. I know, it seems that Cuevas Kirk is one of those guys who's been on the radar screen for a long time.
That's giving my age away, isn't it?
All right, so Bob Lilly has put a little bit more pace into the lineup. His first substitution was out of necessity, the injury suffered by Tyler Bellamy. His second and third put Moto Galvan and Cuevas Kirk into the match. So we'll see if they pay off. Harrisburg is going to get its fifth corner of the night, and this one will come from the far side flag, and Angulo is going to take it. That's something he normally does. Almost to the hour mark, and maybe that's why he doesn't normally take corner kicks. Again, you got to get it over that first line. So we'll try it again, but with his left foot is so very talented that he may be able to place this in a good position. There was a shirt tug there in the box that Rochester got away with. Out of play here on the near side. And Harrisburg will take the throw. Quickly, Mbiji in the corner, and his opposite number, Tyler Rosenlund, was all over him there. And that'll go out of play near side. So again, Bob Lilly has made three substitutions. You get five in this league. Punched out again by Kitson, and then he retreats quickly into his net.
That was good goalkeeping again, reading the situation, you know, coming off your line that far. You know you've got to get to it. He did very well in doing that.
Pelletier now gets it to his right peg, takes a deflection, almost very dangerous for Neil Kitson. I think he had it covered, but he was a little bit surprised by the deflection. It'll be a corner. Most of the action here in the last 6 or 7 minutes has been confined to this end of the field.
And a bunch of corner kicks too.
Yeah, and yeah, that's partially most of it there. He said, mixing metaphors. Basso sends that one across. Mbiji tries to get on the end of that one and very nearly did. Still scoring the 62nd minute. Jagdeo Singh is finally onside. And again, it's clear.
They'll have Rhinos news and interviews and give you a chance to win tickets to the Rhinos match.
Cost now, look for Banks. Banks took a wicked clearance in the face right at the very end of the first half, but he's back in there. He may have that little Umbro insignia on his forehead for a day or so, though. Trainer knocks it long. If that one had been able to get over Welker's head, Jagdeo Singh was there. And Anthony Calvano knocked that one up towards midfield. Moto Galvan has it now. Here's Banks, cuts inside, the corner of the 18. Banks with a shot, saved by Phil Tuttle. First clear chance of the second half for Rochester, and Tuttle equal to the task again. Now we're chasing. Mona Galvan strips his opponent there, and Jagdeo Singh gets it to Hoxie. Hoxie's onside. Here's a chance, and it's snuffed out by Stephen Basso. Action gets a little furious here. That previous chance, Peter, what do we see here?
Well, again, a great ball in Bankster's well, and of course, straight into the goalkeeper's hands. Should have done better with the execution. Probably crossed the keeper to the far post.
Just the second corner of the night for the Rhinos, and Mota Galvan will take it here on the near side flag. That's a nice one to the six, but it drops, and Banks puts it high. And back the other way and up into the seats. Again, Harrisburg in white jerseys and blue shorts and blue socks, and Rochester in the green shirts and white shorts and socks. Actually, when Rochester first came out, they had their home white and black stripes, but it was too similar to the white that Harrisburg was wearing, so Rochester went back in, came back out in the green. And we're hopeful somebody can add some color to this match with a goal. Gulo loses that one. Knocked back by Costanzo. Jagdeo Singh working hard, and he's rewarded. Here's Jagdeo Singh. Jagdeo Singh out, and he scores! In the 65th minute, Kendall Jagdeo Singh puts the Rhinos on top by a goal to nil. Just terrific work.
Yes,
just
to great get the work. All night long, he's been working hard. He's been chasing, and you know, here he gets just reward because he's made some great runs and gotten in behind the defense a couple of times in the first half. Great goal.
And Welker put his hand up as if he was going to maybe try to pull him down or something, and thought better of it. But rather than giving up a last man back situation, he had to lay off. And Kendall Jagdeo Singh cashed in, first goal of this match, and well deserved, as you mentioned. Jagdeo Singh just turned 25 a couple of weeks ago.
That's Jagdeo Singh unassisted.
So happy birthday. They come unassisted officially. Jagdeo Singh second of the year. And Jose Angulo is out of the match, replaced by Jarrett Thayer in the 67th minute.
The substitution for Harrisburg, entering the game is number six, Jarrett Thayer. Replacing number 19, Jose.
Now Jarrett Thayer is primarily a defensive player, Peter. And Bill Boettcher is going to be chasing the goal here without his top goal scorer, Angulo, is out of the match in the 67th minute.
Jaggy, slide left. Hey, go in the middle.
So what do you think they'll look like now? Will they push someone else?
Yeah,
up
it looks like the player just come in. Who was that? Sorry.
Jarrett Thayer, who's a defender.
He's gone into the middle there. So they'll probably push somebody out on the right side. And still, you know, try and go with three.
Yeah,
they'll go back.
There's Hoxie now. Sent to the turf by Bixler. Rather cynical. I would say that deserves a card, and Jason White agrees. Sixty-eighth minute, Justin Bixler booked. And it'll be a free kick here. And Alfonso Mota Galvan will stand over this free kick. About 40 yards from goal. Nice ball into the box. Tuttle drops it there, but picks it back up.
68 minutes.
Here's what brought the card on.
Yeah, just holding him and just, you know, not allowing him to get past definite card.
Now this long ball is comes down and Harrisburg has it back. Mbeji stops, turns, fires it into the box, and we've got a takedown here and a second yellow card. It's going to be on Moto Galvan, it looks like.
They went in a little heavy there.
So after letting some things go by that could have been carded by other referees.
50-50 and
see the aftermath there. Gets him.
That's a card.
Yeah, 2 foot in, and BG is feeling it. Yeah.
Actually, the referee's done very well, you know, and as I said, at halftime, there's been some, you know, physical within the laws of the game, and obviously, when it's outside of the laws of the game like that, made good, great decisions.
So now, a set piece chance for Harrisburg as they try to get the equalizing goal here, as we're in the 70th minute. This free kick will come from about 24 yards off the goal line, but right at the corner of the box. Sent across, and Huxley got ahead on that one for Rochester. Good work by Costanzo to get that out of danger. Throw in for the City Islanders, though. Again, the winner tonight will move into first place. If it's Rochester, they'll have it all to themselves. And if Harrisburg can come back and win, they'll be tied for the top spot with the LA Blues. And here is the goal scorer, Kendall Jagdeosingh, now operating out on the left wing. And he gets hit hard on the far side. He's taken in the head, the ankle.
Yeah. That was a little heavy. I think he's looking, you know, not to get it, a card for that.
Kendall Jagdeosingh is up. He's going to live, but that is a foul. 71st minute. Free kick chance now for Rochester. Moto Galvan from about the same distance as Harrisburg's free kick just a moment ago, but a little bit farther out on the angle. Moto Galvan drives this one in. And Bixler puts it over to the far side. It's kept in there, though, by Moto Galvan. Kost with a left footer into the box.
Protect, pound.
And Rosenlund can't keep that in over on the far side. Well, the City Islanders, Peter, haven't been shut out since their season opener against Pittsburgh, but they're 20 minutes away here from falling without scoring a goal. What do they need to do here in this last 20 minutes?
Well, I think, you know, they've obviously got to push bodies forward and, you know, numbers forward and hope that they can get it without conceding. You know, always hard as a coach, you know, when to really go after it in terms of that final sort of 20 minutes, you know, of the game.
And Saini Touré came into the match and hasn't had many touches since doing so. He's going to be key to Harrisburg chances. So Bill Petcher hopes, and he's going to go to his bench and bring a couple of guys on, and so too will Bob Lilly. So we're going to see Michael Tanky come in the 73rd minute. Tanky's just coming back from an ankle injury. He's going to come in for J.C. Banks.
J.C. Banks, substitution in the 73rd minute.
So that'll come in the 73rd, fourth of five substitutions available to Bob Lilly. And we're going to see Morgan Langley come in for David Schofield. There you see Langley.
For Harrisburg, entering the game is number 15, Morgan Langley, replacing number 10, David Schofield.
And Jeff Blows in as well. Blows comes in for Brian Ombigi.
Substitution for Harrisburg, entering the game, number 4, Jeff Bluss, replacing number 8, Brian Ombigi.
So each team has used 4 subs. Jeff Blows, another one of those local players from Harrisburg, 26-year-old midfielder. Hope that he can give them a spark. Morgan Langley as well. He's quite the goal scorer at Swarthmore College. Scored 14 goals as a senior, number 15 in white. So the offense has been inserted. And with just over 16 minutes to play in this one, the Harrisburg City Islanders are going to be chasing the tying goal. Here's Basso now. Tried to drop that one over the back line, but nothing doing there. Will Traynor sends it up. Quavis Kirk sent that one out off Jeff Blows. Kirk with a high throw in, a wrestling match going on here between Bixler and Hoxie. And Bixler's got to be careful because he's playing with a yellow. Torre plays that one into space to Blows, but Quavis Kirk shows his speed.
Yep, that's Quavis.
Quavis Kirk hasn't been 100%. You see that left thigh wrapped a bit. He's got a little bit of a hamstring, but wanted to get back out there. And so he'll be on for the last 20 minutes or so of this match, having just come in a bit ago. Bixler has that one go off his head. Here's Jagdiasi. It's Michael Tanky. See how his ankle seems to be doing. Flick forward, looking for Hoxie. The Harrisburg defense is there. Basso plays that one long. Troy Roberts. Quavis Kirk, two former LA Galaxy players.
Yeah, Troy Robb has done very, very well. No sign of the injury, and he's held that back line together magnificently.
Again, the Rhinos have only given up 1 goal at home this season. That was to Wilmington. And they're happy to have their captain and glue, as you call them, back in their back four. Their captain. 76 minutes played here. And Rochester leading Harrisburg by a goal to nil. Just a dangerous collision there. If you ask Neil Kitson, he'll say he had it all the way, but Morgan Langley was coming down hard on him. Kitson. Not too long. Kitson scored a dramatic stoppage time goal in the Sunday night match at Antigua, where he was just knocking a ball from just over the center line back into play, and it slipped through the Barracuda FC keeper's hands. He was the first Rochester goalkeeper ever to score a goal, and it gave his team a needed point. They got 4 points, and they're on their way to 3 here tonight if they can hold on for the last 70, or the last 14 minutes or so. Foul called over on the far side. There you see Neil Kitson. Goalkeeper's dream. You never scored one, did you?
Only in my own goals.
Ken Kitson knocks that one long. Drops over the head of Hoxie. And Phil Tuttle, who's played pretty well in goal as well.
Yep. He's done very, very well. He's looked very, very safe and very sharp.
Phil Betcher admitted that it was a tough decision that came right up till game time between him or Chase Harrison. Now it's pushed to Jeff Blows. Quavis Kirk on him. Torre, the shot, stopped by Kitson.
Another good save on the near post there. Good goalkeeping.
And if that one gets through,
Yeah, Terray, good ball, but nearly caught him just leaning off his near post, the keeper.
And Noon was waiting at that back post. If that one had gone through, Noon was waiting to put home the equalizer. Instead, remains a 1-0 match in the 79th minute. And Bill Betcher is going to use his fifth and final substitution on Jordan Seabrook once he gets the opportunity. So he's just going to throw everything up there in an attempt to get the equalizer.
Basically down to three at the back, obviously, and pushing forward.
This is only the second time these two teams have met. They've played in opposite divisions, obviously, for their lifespans, as Jordan Seabrook comes in, number 14. Seabrook, a 23-year-old out of Indianapolis, Indiana, and was four-time all-conference player at the University of South Florida in my hometown of Tampa. Started to say these two teams, they played a month and a day ago, but that was their first meeting in a game that mattered. They played some friendlies over the years, but having been in different divisions, they had never played in the league before and had never played in the Open Cup as well. Here's Jack Diasing. Can he get his second goal? Tunnel out. Forces him outside the box.
Excellent goalkeeping again there. Just to, you know, keep forcing him wide the way he was going and not let him turn back into goal.
There you see the speed here. We're in the 80th minute, and Kendall Jagdeosing, who's been roughed up all game long, still had that burst.
Yeah, but he's got a lot of ability, hasn't he? He's very, very dangerous.
Thrown in the box to Hoxie. Hoxie draws a crowd, and that will go out for a corner. Just the third corner of the night for the Rhinos. Sun not a factor now on Phil Tuttle, as the clouds have largely obscured it. Alfonso Motogalban to take it on the far side flag. Hangs in the air. Goes off Jagdeosing. And out for a goal kick. 81st minute. The crowd here wanted a corner kick. So now here come the City Islanders. In white, looking for the equalizing goal if they can get it. Switch it here to Basso. Had to take a strong first touch because he had pressure from Tanky. Cuevas Kirk up there. It's Motogalban to Rosenlund. Hoxie timed his run nicely, kept himself onside. And again, Andrew Wexler, so steady at the back.
Very, very steady, yeah.
Just when it looks like it's a certain opportunity.
Calvano was caught too wide, too, in his cover position. So that was why they got him behind.
Well, were it not for Mr. Welker, this may not be a 1-0 game anymore. It's snuffed out a couple of clear chances. Will Trainer knocked that one long and then took a tumble. We're at Salem Stadium in Rochester, New York. Welcome any of you who've tuned in early for the USA-Panama match that will immediately follow this one. My name is Ken Tomasz. Peter Meller and I bringing you the first USL Pro Game of the Week here on Fox Soccer. Next week we'll be in Orlando as Orlando City hosts the Wilmington Hammerheads. We are in the 83rd minute with Rochester leading by a goal to nil. That goal by Kendall Jagdeosing in the 65th minute. A nice goal it was. But Harrisburg is looking to try to get level here in the next 8 minutes and change. Rochester would take over first place in the National Division by a point over Los Angeles if they are able to hold on and get the full 3 points. And every one of these eats a few more precious seconds off that clock. Tuttle sends it long. Mo Moto Galvan heads it back. Pelletier chests it down. Basso trying to play it up to Touré. And they haven't been able to get the ball to Touré.
No, they haven't.
Have him do things. Oh, Moto Galvan was looking to pick out Jagdeo Singh here. And Wexler hits Jagdeo Singh in the back. And he goes down again. Bob Lilly has another sub. He may want to use it on just to spare the life of Kendall Jagdeo Singh at this point.
Yeah, he's taking some physical tonight. There's no doubts about that.
Look at this collision.
Yeah. It's like he's got the ball in the back, basically.
Yeah, Welker, that's a bit uncalled for. Kendall Jagdeo Singh's goal in the 65th minute is the difference, but, and he'll remember that, obviously, but he's going to remember this match. Wonder if Bob Lilly will use that fifth and final sub here.
I think Jagdeo Singh probably just knows where we're at in the game and saying, hey, let's get the trainer out, run a few seconds off the clock.
All right, Kendall Jagdeo Singh is up. He'll come off. At least temporarily.
Okay, fans, turn your attention to the scoreboard.
All right, here we go, 85th minute now. Rhinos are temporarily down a man, but up a goal. It'll be magic spray time for Kendall Jagdeo Singh before he gets back in the match.
Congratulations, Tammy.
All right, Harrisburg will throw it back into the Rhinos. And a foul call there as a bit over aggressive by a Harrisburg player. Morgan Langley. Jagdeo Singh is back into the match after making a miraculous recovery. And Neil Kitson in no hurry to put this ball back into play. Kitson now. Seabrook heads it back the other way for Rochester. Moto Galvan, tanky on his horse down in the corner. Can he get there? Got there, but not in time. And now you'll see a bit more urgency from Phil Tuttle than you just saw from Neil Kitson. Tuttle would like to have that one back as he spun it out of play here on the near side. 86 minutes gone by.
Not the time to do that, right? I mean, you're looking for a goal.
Well, Steven Basso apparently feeling it's in safer hands than Phil Tuttle, who will take this goal kick. 87th minute. Does Harrisburg have a dramatic late goal in them to salvage a point, or will Rochester hold on? The cost clears that high.
We're here at Salem Stadium.
Out of play on the far side.
7:35. And fans, don't forget, at the beer cart, $1 beers all game long.
Harrisburg throws it in. Goes off Jeff Lowe's. And again, it's headed back to Tuttle. Now, Basso again. Goes long. Troy Roberts gets ahead to it as it came over the head of Saini Touré. Now, Hoxie alertly turns it back inside and switches the play here to eat a few seconds away. Now they're just playing keep away. Basso with a nice tackle. Moto Galvan. Now this is why you practice one touch.
That's good play. Very good play.
Hoxie top of the arc. turns. Why not have a go? Saved by Tuttle. He'll distribute quickly.
I think the game's lacked a little bit of that, you know, possession, being patient and finding the openings.
Ninth minute. Did Tanky chase this one to the corner? Rosalind down to the byline. Keeps it in. Cuts back into the box. Again, gets it to his right peg. All time in the world. Finally sent out for a corner.
Good play, good balance. Very sort of tricky and lucky.
Tyler Rosenlund, 24-year-old from Vancouver, British Columbia.
Good skills, good change of direction, and lucky.
Rhinos are taking their time. We're in the 90th minute. They'll shortest corner ball you've ever seen.
Yeah, they'll keep this ball right there.
And Drew Costa has that one go out, but it's a very, very deep throw in. Harrisburg has a long way to go and a short time to get there. Teray draws a bead, but Quavis Kurt gets ahead on it. Fouled his man, though, put his hand in the small of his back. Buys him some real estate, but time's still running out. Langley cuts inside Quavis Kurt, cuts inside again. Has a shot, goes off Jordan Seabrook's ankle, but he has it back. Calvano now down in the corner. Sends it across, cleared away. Shot high! Jeff blows.
That's it, they got everybody forward there and looking for that equalizer. Great strike, but a little too high.
4 minutes of stoppage time. Thank Kendall Jagdeosingh for some of that. Kitson knocks it long. Ball won by Calvano. Here come the City Islanders. Push it into Blows. He goes down, no call. Jason White's not hearing of it. It'll be a goal kick. Neil Kitson with a minute gone and 4 minutes of stoppage. Bixler gets ahead to that one. Pelletier for Harrisburg. Intercepted. Jagdeosingh goes down and that. Worthy of a foul? Okay. Excuse me while I tie my shoe.
That's it. You know, we've got the game won if they do sensible things now, but that can also change.
Kick by Rochester. Smartly sent to the other side of the field. Jordan Seabrook keeps it in for Harrisburg. Tanky is there down in the corner. Halfway through stoppage time. 2 minutes to play. Saini Teray. Will Trainer goes down. Harrisburg has to work quickly. About a minute and a half left. Pelletier knocks it long. And Troy Roberts, as he has been all night, is right there. Kendall Jagdeosingh, 2.5 minutes deep in stoppage. Calvano to Pelletier. Drew Cost on him. Sent long, Jeff Blows is there. Again, so is the Rochester defense. Here's Blows trying to get it to his right foot. Oh, it eludes Jordan Seabrook. Just over a minute to play. Hoxie. Oh, Mona Galvan was calling for the ball. He's making a run down the center of the field, and Hoxie just knocked it long.
Not really a good decision at this stage of the game. Should have just kept the ball.
Because Harrisburg has it back. Jeff Blows, top of the box. Toure cleared out. Again, they look for Blows. Spins around Cuevas Kirk. Kirk gets in, shepherds it across the line, and that's it for a goal kick. Here may have been the last chance saloon right here, Peter.
Yeah, that probably was it. Last chance. But,
great defending again. This may be the last act. It's Neil Kitson's goal kick. The longest run-up in the history of goal kicks. Basso wins the header. Jason White checks his watch. Blows the whistle, and we're done. Kendall Jagdia sings. 65th minute goal was the difference as Rochester beats Harrisburg by a goal to nil, and they go into first place in the National Division. Thank you for watching. We'll be in Orlando next week. The final again, Rochester 1-0. For Peter Meller, I'm Ken Tomash. For our whole crew, good night from Rochester.
Find out why X-Men First Class is the best reviewed movie of the summer.
How's that for a magic trick?
Best I've ever seen.
X-Men First Class, certified fresh, rated PG-13.
Things seem 45% better when you save up to 45% at Travelocity.
Our girl's an architect.
Our boy's a genius.
You look amazing.
You look like a beach angel.
Save up to 45% summer vacations at Travelocity.
It's go time.
I will send this to Shelley, yeah. And I can have a proposal to you within a half an hour.
We're a small business. With 27 of us always in the field, we have to stay connected. We use Verizon tablets, smartphones. We're more responsive. There are no delays.
Okay, good.
Delays cost money. With Verizon, we do things quicker and more effectively.
More small businesses choose Verizon Wireless than any other wireless carrier because they know the small business with the best technology rules.
Trouble, bad dog in my school since the day I was born. Worry, oh, worry, 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 worry.
Whoa. When it comes to things you care about, leave nothing to chance. Travelers, take the scary out of life.
Thanks to the Venture Card from Capital One, we get double miles on every purchase. So me and the lads earned a trip to San Francisco twice as fast. We get double miles every time we use our card.
I'll take these two, no matter what we're buying.
And all of those?
And since double miles add up fast, we can bring the whole gang. It's hard to beat double miles.
Whoa, dude.
Get the Venture Card from Capital One and earn double miles on every purchase every day. Go to CapitalOne.com.
What's in your wallet?
The world's favorite pastime comes to America in search of gold. With golds from Altidore and Dempsey against Canada. Next up, the States take on Panama. Gold Cup, live tonight, only on Fox Soccer. Presented by Chevy.
Soccer night in America. It's a Northwestern rivalry as the Sounders look to dominate the Whitecaps. Live tonight on Fox Soccer.
WPS is on Fox Soccer. The Western New York Flash take on the Philadelphia Independents. Live tomorrow, presented by Puma.
Witness the next chapter of an eternal rivalry. The 2011 State of Origin Series. Queensland, New South Wales, in an all-out war. Live exclusively on Fox Soccer.
The 2011 Gold Cup pregame show is presented by Chevrolet. Share the excitement on the field with Chevrolet's Football Mania.
A very hot, sunny, and humid Tampa, Florida is our venue today as our coverage of the 2011 Gold Cup continues here on Fox Soccer. An impressive result for the United States against Canada has them sitting on top of Group C. They share that position with their opponent today, the United States taking on Panama from Raymond James Stadium in Tampa, Florida. Looking forward to this one. Welcome into our studios here in Los Angeles. Eric Winalda with Hall of Famer Kobe Jones. As we prepare for this one, what are our expectations today? We saw a pretty good result against Canada. Panama, a good team, but we expect the U.S. to win.
Exactly. High expectations today from the U.S. Let's be honest, Eric. We're expecting a whooping.
Just a flat-out whooping.
That's what it comes down to. Obviously, it could take a while, but I think once one goal comes, it's going to start to flow for the U.S.
All right, it wasn't a whooping against Canada, but it was a pretty good result. Let's take a look back at it. We got some goals in Detroit. Last time we were in Detroit.